Let's do an example of the first derivative test. Before we put the example up, let me make an observation that we're going to use that critical values are the only places where the derivative of a function can potentially change sign. We'll see why this is important in a moment, but for now, let me put the example we're going to do up. Let's find and classify local extrema of this cubic polynomial. Well, we'll need to start by finding the critical values where the derivative either does not exist or equals 0. The derivative is a quadratic. A quadratic is defined everywhere. So there are no critical values as a result of the derivative not existing. There might be critical values caused by the derivative equaling 0. This is a quadratic. You can solve it using the quadratic formula. If you plug that into your calculator, we're going to need decimal approximations. We're going to need to know about what these numbers are. 0.45 and 2.22. And now we're going to create a number line and mark the critical values. Zero point four five, 2.22. So here's where this comes into play. The critical values are the only values where the derivative can change sign. So if we look at this interval, for example, there are no critical values in this interval, so the derivative can't change sign. It's either always positive or always negative. And let's take a number and plug it into the derivative. Any number at all between this and this. Let's say one. If we plug one into the derivative, we get 3 - 8 + 3. That's a negative number. And the derivative can't change sign between these critical values. So since it's negative somewhere, it's negative everywhere between the critical values. Similarly, to the right of this critical value, the derivative can't change sign. It's either always negative or always positive. So pick any number to the right of this. It doesn't matter what number specifically you pick, 3, 5, 10, anything bigger than 2.22. Let's go with 3. Take 3, plug it in here. 27 plus 3 is 30 minus 24, positive. So since it can't change sign, since it's positive somewhere, it's positive everywhere. To the left of the critical value, again, it can't change sign in here. It's always negative or always positive. Let's look at 0. 0 is in this interval. At 0, the derivative is positive, positive 3. And now that we've filled in this sign chart, we can use the first derivative test. From positive to negative is a local max. From negative to positive is a local min.